Web components enable you to build great websites through the use of reusable components. But what does it take to build a web component? My name is Eiji, and today I'm going to give you an overview of custom elements. Custom elements are a key feature in web components that lets you create your own HTML tags. Given the original purpose of HTML tag as a script language for documents, it has a limited vocabulary for elements, which means we end up relying on divs and existing markup to structure pages. Custom elements will change that. Some frameworks, such as AngularJS, provide a way to define your own tags. But they are specific to the framework and not reusable. With custom elements, you can define and register new DOM elements, as well as inherit and extend existing DOM elements. These differences make custom elements easier to handle, not only for element authors, but also for developers who use them. At the time of this recording, custom elements have landed in Chrome and Opera. Firefox supports it innately behind a flag. But support for web components is changing weekly, so be sure to check chromestatus.com for an up-to-date browser support table. To detect the availability of the custom element, check if document register element is available. For unsupported browsers, you can use platform.js, a collection of web components polypill made available as a part of Polymer library. This will automatically detect the availability of the custom elements and polypill it if necessary. Registering a custom element is simple. Just call document register element with a new tag name as an argument. This will register a new tag name, in this case, xComponent, which you can then start using in your document. The tag name must be separated with dash. Anything other than that will return errors. You can use those custom elements not only declaratively as an HTML tag, but also imperatively using JavaScript. One way is to use the constructor written by document register element. You can instantiate the constructor to obtain a DOM object. Because custom elements are just like any other HTML element, you may also use document create element to create a new instance. Once you learn how to define and register a custom tag, you should also want to add some features to it. You can do so by inheriting existing elements prototype. First, create a new object from HTML element prototype by using object create. This new object will be the prototype for your element. Then add your own properties and methods to it. When registering the custom element, pass an object as a second argument, which has a prototype object as a value of key prototype. Now you can use the xComponent custom element in your HTML. If you inspect down the xComponent element on DevTools, it will look something like this. xComponent element is an instance of xComponent prototype, which has a property and the method you have just defined, alert and name. And this element is inherited from HTML element, so it has all the features HTML element provides. You can also extend an existing element, which is called type extension custom element. To extend an element, give the second argument in register element an object with extends and prototype as keys. For extends, give it as tag name string you want to extend from, for example, input. For prototype, give it the base element's prototype. If you are extending from input element, use HTML input element. For using type extension custom element, add the custom element's name as a value of its attribute to the extended element. To imperatively create a DOM object of the element, add the tag name as the second argument to create element. You may wonder what are use cases for type extension custom element. Actually, there's already a really good example in the wild. If you go to GitHub, you can find lots of sections that indicate relative time. If you take a look into one of them using DevTools, you will notice it is actually a time tag with an extension of relative time. Notice that DateTime attribute indicates an absolute time. This is achieved by using type extension custom element. The relative time type extension automatically calculates relative time and appends it to the time element as a text content. To learn more about time element, please visit its GitHub repository. I mentioned that relative time type extension appends a string to the element as a text content. But when does that happen? Custom elements support lifecycle callbacks that enable you to manipulate DOM on certain timings. There are four types of lifecycle callbacks. Created callback. This is called after the element is created. Attached callback. This is called when the element is attached to the document. Detached callback. This is called when the element is detached from the document. Attribute changed callback. This is called when one of the element's attribute is changed. Relative time type extension hooks into created callback and attribute changed callback and manipulate the element's text content. In order to use those lifecycle callback, you can simply add them to the prototype object when registering a custom element. Once inside of created callback, you can leverage the power of template and shadow DOM to add additional contents to our element. Let me show you an example. So this is a template we are adding custom elements content, followed by an actual HTML that displays the custom element. Since this is an exactly same code we used in the shadow DOM video, I'm not going to explain how to use template and shadow DOM. If you haven't watched them, please do so. For JavaScript, we can use similar skeleton as we used in the earlier example. In order to create shadow root, first add created callback as a property of custom elements prototype. Then call create shadow root on this object. To stamp out template, pick the template DOM element using query selector. Then clone it using document import node and append it to the shadow root. And finally, register the custom element. The result will look something like this. So this is a custom element. To learn more about custom elements, be sure to read the HTML5 Rocks article written by Eric Biderman. Thank you for watching. See you in the next episode.